Dr. Tolchin is now at our 3D model. So doctor, can you explain to us what we're looking at here at this biodigital?
Yes, certainly. So here we are looking at the spine. This is a cross-sectional view of the spine. This is where the disc would be. These are some of the bony elements in the back. And then this is the key feature here that's lighting up in red. This is the canal. So we talk about lumbar stenosis. Mm-hmm. It's really narrowing of this canal. This canal should be round, but what's happening here is the disc is bulging back into the canal and causing compression of those nerves. And these are the nerves then that come out the side. When these are compressed, or all of the nerves are compressed in the canal, we call that condition lumbar spinal stenosis.
Can I ask you, why is it that when those patients that do have the lumbar stenosis, they feel that numbness down their legs and that weakness?
Yes, absolutely, because that's because these nerves are essentially trapped in a finite space now. It was a wide open space, but now they're being squeezed, and when they're squeezed, they lose oxygen and blood supply to the nerves. And if I could have the next slide for a second also, what happens when the nerves are squeezed, they start up here in the spine, but they go down the leg in the distribution of the nerve. So you can kind of see down the distribution that's lighting up in red.
And that's
this
that
would
sharp
be
pain.
The L5 nerve root, for example, that's going into the top of the leg and top of the foot. And that's because it's being pinched up here in the back. And that's lumbar stenosis, essentially. And when it happens to multiple nerves, you get feelings on both sides of the legs of this numbness and tingling.
So it can happen on both legs simultaneously?
It usually does. When the spinal stenosis advances to a moderate or severe degree, then it can happen on both legs.